Good morning, everybody. I don't even know what day it is. I have no clue what day it is. I want to say it's the 7th of September. I've been really bad about vlogging. I've been very, very inconsistent. My hair's fucking... I hate my hair, dude, so much. I'm very bad about vlogging. I've been very inconsistent. And, trying to be more consistent, but it's, well, I don't know, there's not really anything interesting happening, and I don't really have a lot to say about a lot of things, so, but I'm gonna try to kind of pretend that I do, because I wanna, like, building consistency is the main thing that I wanna do when it comes to this kind of thing, so, it doesn't really matter. If there's nothing to say and only talk about the workout, that's fine. But I just want to be consistent in what I'm doing. So, with that being said, let's go check the weight this morning. Okay, so 280 on the dot. It's like, it's trolling me, essentially. It's like, it won't even show me a 7. Like, all I want to see is a 7. But hopefully, by the end of this week, we'll reach 7. I know I'm already starting off on a bad foot, being obsessed about the 7. But man, it would really feel like I'm making real progress, because I've been bouncing from 280, like, essentially like 280 to 285 for like a long time. And I feel like if I reach the 70s again, that's when it's like real progress has been made. You know, this is already more successful than the last couple of times. So, what am I going to have today? Let's see. I got regular monsters right here. I got some 3D, the new ghost flavor, and a lot of low carb. And I think I'm going to have a low carb monster. I'm one of the weirdos that actually loves the taste of original monster. That's just my favorite. It is actually my favorite flavor of Monster, is original. Low carb does a very good job at imitating it while being, you know, low in calories, only 30 calories a can. So this is what we're doing. This is how it has to be done. I'm gonna go ahead and crack the cold one open, drink it, and I don't know, I'll find something to talk about, I guess. I'll see you guys later. Whoa! That's not good. Relax. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the pre-workout section of the video. Just pulled up to the gym. Kind of a boring day. Didn't really do anything. Nothing really going on. I've been trying to work out a video that I wanted to make about my program. I realize that I have not really talked about it too much. Again, this is going on to the, in addition to the fact that I just, have just not been very good at vlogging. I'm just gonna just turn this off right now. I have not been very good at vlogging, I know. So, like, there's a lot of ideas that I've got, and I've kind of got idea overload. So it's like, there are things that I want to talk about, and there's more things I want to talk about, and then obviously it's like, oh, what do I start first? And it's like, nothing ever gets done because it's just too much. So what I'm probably going to need to do is just, you know, make a list of things in order to do, and just start knocking them out, you know, and stop procrastinating. As you guys know, that is my biggest issue, is the procrastination. So gonna be focusing on that a bit later, especially after this workout is done. But this workout is going to signal the first real leg training session that I've had since my injury that happened, 2 months ago now? It's been 2 months since I've really trained my legs properly. So this is either going to go really good or really bad. Now, I have a strategy as to what I'm going to do following the, injury. So I'm not going to be going at a super high intensity
right out the gate, which is going to be a bit of a, you know, like, oh, I just want to make some gains. Like, come on. Like, should I just do it? Should I stop being a pussy type thing? But I'm realizing that that's kind of like my ego talking. My ego wants me to use weights that I know I can smash previously before the injury because I want to hit PRs. It's like, that's like my main goal is to hit PRs. And I've got to kind of reel myself in a little bit. And, you know, just pull it back and realize that now is not the time. Like, we are setting up to hit PRs down the road. So, you know, I don't need this block to be like a PR block, right? I just needed to sort of get back in the groove of training and understand this is setting up down the road, right? So, like, maybe next block, maybe two more blocks. And definitely by the end of the year, I'll probably have hit, hopefully, at least a somewhat of a PR, at least an ability PR. But we've got plans. We are going to move forward with those plans. And I just got to realize, again, you got to put the ego away. I've been very ego-driven for a lot of my, not just lifting career, but just my life in general has been very ego-driven. And one of the things that I really want to do is pull back on letting the ego sort of rule me, you know. I think there's a time and place for, you know, like strategic, I would say, like, egotism or egotistical behavior. Like, you can use it to your advantage, but again, it's very strategic and it has to be done in a way that is not going to be harmful for you. So like maybe when you're in comp, right? And you're like, you got to have like a sort of overinflated sense of self if you need to hit a big lift or something like that. There's a fine line between confidence and arrogance. And even arrogance can be used to your advantage sometimes. But I know for me personally, especially right now, it's not the time for that. Got the pre right here. This is a combination of two flavors of C4. I'm not a huge C4 guy, but like C4 is like the most popular pre-workout. And like, especially if you go on Amazon to shop for pre's, which I don't usually do, but other people in my family, they love to go on Amazon to get huge discounts on supplements. And I'm like, I don't really care about any of that. But, you know, they bought like three tubs for like $70 or something like that. So this is a combination of two flavors. This is a cherry limeade with the fruit punch flavor in here. I've had this combo before and I hate it, but I gotta get through these bottles. It's not terrible, but it's not great. About to go in, hit some legs. Won't be very intensive. These leg days are low exercise selection. Because, of course, of the injury, I don't want to put too much tonnage on my lower body. Let's hope this one goes well.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the commentary part of the video. Now, I screwed up in two major ways. The first way is I procrastinated, like I said in the other clip. It's like a prophecy. It's like a self-fulfilling prophecy. I prophesized I would procrastinate, and as a result of my inability to actually do work on time, I'm recording this voiceover on the 12th, even though these clips were taken from the 7th. So I've done a full week of training, essentially, up until this point. So that's wonderful, but I decided to throw in these clips in just to show you guys lower days. And then the second way is that I totally screwed up my squat protocol. I did my deload week protocol on squats for some reason. I don't know how I messed this up. I was looking at the wrong spreadsheet for the squats. So instead of doing a 6x6 on the first day and then a set of 8 and then 3 sets of 5x6 on the second day, I did 3x4 on the first day and 3x5 on the second day. I don't know how I screwed that up so bad, but I don't know. I need some help. Somebody help me. So really quick, the first day, I believe this is 280 pounds for a 3x4. Very easy. The intensity was just fine. This is actually the heaviest I squatted up until this point. And then for my conventional deadlifts, we did a top set of 5
at what was supposed to be a relatively high intensity. But I have pulled back my intensity for this week, as I was talking about in the other clips. So what I've done is, instead of operating off of my absolute one rep maxes, which are pretty old, they're about 18 months old. So maybe it's like I'm pulling back intensity more than I should be. But instead of operating off of those one rep maxes, I've reduced both my maxes on my squat and deadlift by about 10%. So we're working with a max of 380 for the squat and 365 for the deadlift. That results in the weights being very reduced and me like not really being challenged. But that's kind of what I was talking about in the previous clip, where I was like, this is all about ramping. And because I've spent the last 2 months not training lower at all, pretty much, like other than doing some isolation stuff, I think this is a necessary thing to do. So we pulled back intensity and we're gonna ramp. And I know I'm not gonna set any PRs this block, and maybe not even set any PRs the next block, but the block after that and the block after that, up until the end of the year, we should be setting PRs. Like, that is the goal. So the second squat day where I screwed up and didn't do the protocol, this is a 3x5 with 300. Very, very easy. I'm just happy that I'm doing this pain-free. Like, I'm 100% pain-free on both the squats and the deadlifts, which is great because I'm working both the stances on the deadlifts. So the second deadlift day is a different stance. It's sumo. My primary stance is conventional. I pull sumo on the second day. I'm not very good at sumo. So, and I've always kind of, interestingly enough, you'd think that it would be a lot easier because you can get more vertical and there's less range of motion. But I've actually been like way more prone to lower back pain on sumo just because my setup is all kinds of whack and I'm just too big to get into proper position. So with that being said, very happy. No pain whatsoever. So I'm really looking forward to ramping. I set the sumo weight at the same weight as my conventional weight. So my conventional was 295 and my sumo was also 295. And because sumo volumizes, the weight's gonna stay the same probably. But with the conventional intensifying, we're gonna get up there. So yeah, screw the lower body protocol. Sorry about that, guys. I will pay much more attention to my spreadsheets in the future. And with that, I'll see you guys later.
Okay. Whoa. What's going on, everybody? So that voiceover was recorded on the 12th. It's on the 15th that I'm recording this part of the outro. So originally, when I was going to do the outro, it was going to be like more of a deeper discussion about my thoughts and feelings about the ego, stuff like that, and how this time around, how I'm going to avoid those pitfalls. But then, I kid you not, I recorded the voiceover like on the 12th. It was past midnight. I went to bed, and in the morning, I woke up super sick. Like, I'm sure you can tell. Like, my voice has been, it's just been terrible. I have like this cold. I thought it was the Rona, but I don't think it was because I could still taste it, and like I had a little fever, but it wasn't crazy. And I had family members who were sick who I saw recently, and I'm pretty sure they're the ones that gave this to me. It's been pretty terrible. I haven't been able to lift. I think I'm at the tail end of it, even though I don't sound super great. I think this is like pretty much like the end of it, and then maybe I'll have some issues tomorrow, but after that, I think I should be okay. So we might head back to the gym at that point and start making some content at that point. But yeah, the unlucky, unfortunate. Anyway, with all that being said, I'm just gonna go ahead and close out this video and actually finish the video because I thought I was gonna have to scrap this, but I decided, you know what? I'm not gonna let all the work I did editing the video go to waste. I'm not gonna let this footage go to waste this time. Being consistent is the most important thing, and I really want to get this done. So, yeah, I'm going to rest my voice now, and hopefully see you guys in the next one, in which I'm feeling a lot better. Peace.